Nova Scotia says it's taking a cautious approach to reopening. Officials announced a five-step plan today that is tied to case counts, hospitalizations, and vaccination rates.
I think we've learned in Nova Scotia that a slow, cautious approach actually works, and that doing that allows you to move forward. One of the things we've heard consistently through all our consultations is from all the business sectors, we do not want to lock down again. That would be the worst possible thing.
The first phase begins next Wednesday when groups of up to 10 people can gather outdoors. Schools outside Halifax and Sydney can resume in-class learning. Restaurants will be able to open outdoor patios, provided there is physical distancing. Phase 2 will eliminate travel restrictions within the province, and it would allow indoor gatherings of 10 people. Restaurants can resume indoor dining. Phase 3 would see the Atlantic bubble be re-established. Personal services will fully reopen. Phase 4 would allow Canadian travelers from outside Atlantic Canada. Retail would be open at maximum capacity with distancing and masking still in place. And Iain Rankin, the Premier of Nova Scotia, joins us now. He is in Halifax. Premier, thank you very much for taking some time with us this afternoon. There is this inevitable temptation, because all these provinces have now released various reopening plans and there are differences, to make comparisons. One thing that I note is that some other provinces sort of have target dates, and you do for the first phase of your five-phase plan, and that's June 2nd. But we don't see it for any of the other dates. Why is that? Why are there not hard dates attached to any of the other phases?
We believe it provides more flexibility to public health to make that determination. This plan is based on data and not dates. But we do have approximately, looking at the timelines, of 2 to 4 weeks between each phase, so that we have a relative certainty for our businesses to start to prepare for reopening. But I think it would be irresponsible to put a specific date in mind without knowing the epidemiology at that time and the circumstances around what's happening with the contact tracing and the other milestones that we put in place. But I think it does provide that predictability that that businesses are looking for, but at the same time, it allows us to make evidence-based decisions on the science on the ground.
And as I look at the differences between provinces, I think Nova Scotia until recently had basically no COVID to deal with, whereas, say, Alberta had a lot of COVID to deal with. Alberta's plan sees basically no restrictions by about Canada Day. Nova Scotia's plan continues with some forms of restrictions and limitations through to the fall. What are Nova Scotians, what are Canadians to make of that difference with your plan?
Well, we're very much focused on what we need to do to get through our third wave. So we locked down the whole province quickly when we saw the first sign of it. So it's been exactly 1 month today that we had that shutdown in place. And we showed that tough restrictions, when you follow them, work to arrest the trend of increasing cases. And we did have triple-digit cases, unfortunately, and it resulted in hospitalizations, ICUs, and ultimately, unfortunately, we lost some Nova Scotians over this third wave. And so we needed to take the matters very seriously. And I believe that taking that approach, quickly shutting down, and then when you're able to start to look at a reopening, that you do so in a manner that's cautious, that's based on science. That's what we did in previous waves. Mm-hmm. And we don't want to have to shut down again. We want to have this in place so that it's really going to last this time. And I think the Nova Scotia approach, working very closely with public health and not just bringing in half measures, worked so that we were able to get through our third wave, as I said, in 1 month. And we're still very cautious looking at the numbers. They're looking very well, as you say, now. They're coming down. Our areas of concern are limited to the two city centers in the province, but it does look good.
The Atlantic bubble, lots of talk about that. PEI talking about it during its reopening plan yesterday. At this point, you're not looking at restoring that until phase 3 of your plan, so probably at some point in July. Are you concerned about the impact that could have on the province's tourism industry?
We've always said that the strong public health measures end up being the most beneficial economic measures in the long term. So that's why we've taken a strict approach. But our phase three, if things go well, because we have approximately 2 to 4 weeks between phases, we actually end up around the same date, the late June to early July, that both New Brunswick and Prince Edward Island are forecasting for the bubble. So we think that we're in the same range of that date, but we have to really make sure that we're getting our cases down and monitoring what's happening there, and our vaccination rates continue to climb. So it's all good signs right now, but we do in Nova Scotia take that cautious approach.
I want to talk to you about the U.S. border, particularly in relation to tourism and the reliance in previous years on American tourists. We understand that a federal advisory panel advised the federal government last night, first of all, to get rid of quarantine hotels, saying, you know, they don't work, there's a discrepancy, or they don't work just as well as sending people home. But it also suggests that you could have fully vaccinated people excused from any kind of quarantine, partially vaccinated people have a limited amount of quarantine. Federal government doesn't seem to be in any rush to reopen the border in that way. What are your concerns? What would you say, what have you said to the Prime Minister about the U.S. border?
We met the premiers with the Prime Minister last evening, and border concerns were brought in various ways by different premiers. Again, Nova Scotia has taken the approach that we want to have strict border measures. So even with our first couple of phases, we keep our strong border measures in place, and not until phase three are we even open to the idea of Atlantic. The first dose of vaccine doesn't get us to where we need to be for the kind of protection that we believe we need for visitors coming internationally. Mm-hmm. Once we have second doses into arms, which should be late summer to early fall, we'll have greater comfort level. But as you know, this virus is unpredictable. There's variants of concern across the globe that are having an impact in different countries. So we need to continue to watch the evolving science, and the advice from the National Advisory Group is just one part of how we assess what we need to do to keep Nova Scotians safe.
I want to talk about the people in between. So not the Atlantic bubble, but people who would want to visit Nova Scotia, visit family who would be coming from somewhere outside of the Atlantic provinces, but not coming from, say, the United States, from another country. What kind of timeline is realistic for them to expect to be able to visit without a 14-day quarantine?
So most optimistically, we're looking at middle July, and that's with the assumption that we're able to get through each phase in the minimum two-week period of time. But we could be looking at August, and we need to make sure that we are assessing the success of opening up to Atlantic first. We know that the other provinces will make different determinations on their own of when they're going to be open to different parts of the country. So there's a lot to consider, as you know, in public health. We're very close, Dr. Strang and I, when we make those determinations of what we're allowing in through our border. We have extremely strict measures in place right now that we're going to start to cautiously look at relaxing, but we need to make sure that the testing continues in Nova Scotia. We're testing more per capita. We're going to continue to do that throughout all phases. We believe that testing should remain in place and become more of the norm across Canada. So I'll continue to advocate that with my colleagues and continue to have the vaccine roll go and make sure that our protection of our public health measures continue based on where we are with our epidemiology.
I'm already out of time, but just to clarify what you're saying, would you be comfortable with testing replacing a quarantine at some point?
That's part of the discussion. So in our next phase, we do have testing at the airport installed. Mm-hmm. We are going to have some type of testing available at our land border for other travel in. But we need to make sure that we have all of these various policy points working in tandem, testing, vaccination, and public health measures.
Premier Iain Rankin, thank you very much for your time. Have a great weekend.
You too. All the best.
Hi, I'm Vashi Capello's host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video.